Hello, I'm Dr. Catherine Satterwhite, epidemiologist in the Division of STD Prevention at the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. I'm also the lead author of the new paper released in February of 2013, estimating the number of prevalent and incident sexually transmitted infections in the United States. Every year in the United States, there are nearly 20 million new sexually transmitted infections, or STIs. Nearly half of these infections occur in young people aged 15 to 24 years. The high number of incident STIs in the United States underscores the ongoing need for increased prevention efforts. Most of these STIs will not cause harm. However, if left untreated, some of them can lead to serious health issues. Undiagnosed and untreated chlamydia or gonorrhea, for example, can increase a woman's chances of infertility. Increasing strains of drug-resistant gonorrhea have made successful treatment of the infection more difficult and have prompted CDC to update recommendations for its treatment regimen. In addition, some types of human papillomavirus infections, or HPV, can lead to genital warts and cervical cancer. For these reasons, it is important for clinicians to talk to their young patients about STI prevention and appropriate testing. Young people often face unique prevention challenges, including embarrassment and confidentiality concerns. Research shows that young patients may be afraid to initiate a conversation about STIs and will be looking to you, their healthcare provider, to begin the discussion. During these conversations, it is important for you to create an environment that feels safe for your young patients to talk openly without judgment. It is also important that you make it clear that you understand that their health needs are different from the health needs of adults. Discussing your young patient's sexual history is a good starting point for these discussions and will help you determine what tests and prevention counseling messages are necessary for your patient. For more information on how to take a sexual history, please visit www.cdc.gov/std. The new CDC analysis also estimated about 110 million prevalent or existing STIs. As with incident infections, HPV accounts for the majority of prevalent infections. Although the body's immune system clears most HPV on its own within 2 years, some infections persist and can cause genital warts, cervical cancers, and other cancers. While there is no treatment for the virus itself, vaccines are available to prevent some of the most important types of HPV infection, including two of the most common types of HPV that can lead to cervical cancer. And given that most sexually active men and women will get HPV at some point in their lives, many can benefit from the protection that the HPV vaccine provides. Currently, HPV vaccine is routinely recommended for 11 or 12-year-old boys and girls as part of the adolescent vaccine schedule that also includes Tdap and the meningococcal vaccine. HPV vaccine is most effective when given before sexual debut. CDC also recommends HPV vaccination for teen girls and women through age 26 and teen boys and men through age 21 who have not been previously vaccinated. CDC recommends HPV vaccination for gay, bisexual, and other men who have sex with men through age 26 who have not been previously vaccinated. CDC also recommends screening for the following STIs. All adults and adolescents between the ages of 13 and 64 years should be tested at least once for HIV, regardless of recognized risk factors. Adolescents and adults at increased risk for HIV infection, such as those who have unprotected sex with multiple partners or exchange sex for money or drugs, should be tested annually. Clinicians also should screen all pregnant women for HIV. All sexually active women aged 25 and younger should be tested for chlamydia every year. At-risk sexually active women should be tested for gonorrhea each year. This includes women with new or multiple sex partners or women who live in communities with a high burden of disease. In addition, all sexually active, gay, bisexual, and other men who have sex with men should be tested at least once a year for syphilis, chlamydia, gonorrhea, and HIV. Those who have multiple or anonymous partners should be screened more frequently. For more detailed information about how to talk to your patients about sexually transmitted diseases or printable fact sheets to pass along to them, please visit CDC's STD homepage at www.cdc.gov/std.